The price of Matic, which is the native token of Polygon, obviously has gone up almost 10,000% year to date. And this is after billionaire investor Mark Cuban confirmed to CoinDesk that he's made an investment in Polygon.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to Investing Guide. Mark Cuban, the Dallas Mavericks professional basketball team owner, recently invested a significant amount of money in Polygon. Polygon is not yet part of the top five cryptocurrencies in the world. So, why did the billionaire entrepreneur choose Polygon out of all of the cryptocurrencies? For today's video, we'll discuss the reasons why Mark Cuban is said to have a lot of faith in Polygon. Following the market's collapse, many investors started seeking for the next big thing. Polygon seems to have captured their interest. Make sure to stick around to know how it managed to survive and thrive when other cryptocurrencies suffered. Before we start, if you like this type of content, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and turn on our notifications so you don't miss out on any of our new updates in the world of investing. Whenever there is a market decline, there is always a good project that survives. Then when the market recovers, it outperforms the rest of it by a wide margin. Polygon is one of the coins that has recently done so. It is on fire right now, and people claim that there aren't many signs of it slowing down. Mark Cuban recently revealed on Twitter that he'd invested in Polygon. Although the exact amount of the investment is not yet mentioned, it is significant enough that Cuban has identified Polygon as one of his portfolio companies. Polygon, formerly known as Matic Network, is an Indian blockchain scaling platform named Ethereum's Internet of Blockchains. It is said to be the solution to some of Ethereum's current problems. Despite Elon Musk's decision to temporarily stop taking Bitcoin payments for Tesla, Cuban announced that the Mavericks, his basketball outfit brand, will keep accepting cryptos. So, what motivated the owner of the Dallas Mavericks to continue transacting with crypto and particularly invest in Polygon? First of all, it was reported that Cuban is working on several crypto-related ventures, and Polygon has a number of blockchain-based projects, which will add to his reasons for investing. Next, he's a business force to be reckoned with, and he's in talks with the platform's creator. Mark didn't simply just put money into Polygon's token. He put money into the company as a whole. This investment is crucial, since he is now at risk of losing more than simply just his money. His good name is on the line too. It just most likely proves that he must genuinely believe in Polygon's potential and has every intention of assisting other investors in realizing that potential. In February 2021, Mark Cuban discussed how he evaluates the crypto industry and picks what to invest in. His impressive experience as a businessman flows into his crypto mindset. While he recognizes the value of Bitcoin and Ethereum, he's more focused on practical business applications. He's looking to invest in businesses, technology, and entrepreneurs in the hopes that they would survive and thrive. As a result, people see that he invested in Polygon for this reason. He believes it has a real-world application that can yield significant results by increasing efficiency on things. He is not the only one who thinks this. On the Polygon website, there are around 270 decentralized applications listed as of May 27, 2021. Cuban believes it is a competitive company that will weather the market's ups and downs in the future years. He could very well be correct. The recent crypto meltdown did not affect Polygon nearly as severely as the rest of the market. Cuban also shared his thoughts about Polygon with Cointelegraph, saying that Polygon is fast, works well, and most importantly, the network's user base is growing exponentially. This is why other experts side with Cuban and predict that Polygon won't have a hard time reaching the $5 mark. We can tell that the famous entrepreneur is focused on business application and marketability. This is why Cuban claims that having more transactions per second and cheaper gas prices are insufficient. A present network effect and strong user growth are also needed. In addition, in the crypto space, it appears like Cuban is seeing a change. The technology is finally getting to the stage where cryptocurrency can be used in the real world. This is why the famous personality is implying that marketing is just as important as solid technology. When questioned about what he offers to the table, he stated, "I can give them feedback on marketing, and we are in the process of integrating Polygon into Lazy.com, which we think will be very beneficial to creating a platform to extend NFTs and personal galleries." Meanwhile, here's what Polygon's co-founder had to say about Mark Cuban. "It was so spectacular to know the nuances about the industry, the tech, and the adoption that we'd figured out after months of grind. He was already thinking about those and had those questions in mind." He's highly praising Cuban's level of knowledge here. When you combine Polygon's great technology with Cuban's marketing expertise, it is easy to picture a rising trend for the coin's market cap. As mentioned earlier, Mark Cuban is not the only one who recognizes that Polygon has to give. To save money on fees, hundreds of decentralized applications, digital programs that exist and run on a blockchain, switched from Ethereum to Polygon. One of the reasons they are switching is that the gas fees of Ethereum can quickly spiral out of hand. Charges were crazy during the peak of the Dogecoin frenzy. Moreover, the prices of Uniswap were hundreds of dollars. If you have a small application that requires a vast number of transactions in a short period, this is far too high. On the other hand, thousands of transactions per second can be handled by the network of Polygon. Fees for a million transactions are roughly $1, so you can understand why relaunching decentralized apps with Polygon is so appealing to developers. It definitely saves them a lot of money in terms of fees. Meanwhile, a new challenge is coming in Polygon's way. Ethereum has promised a 2.0 update sometime this year, which would most likely lower its fees to the point where these digital applications will be less inclined to use Polygon. What is Polygon's plan to survive this? The network states that it does more than merely lower expenses. It is said to be more secure, open, and powerful. Due to the high costs, Polygon began as a scaling option for Ethereum. It is currently known as Ethereum's Internet of Blockchains. The company's current goal is to establish a platform that would allow many different blockchains to interact. It provides several advantages to these blockchains and assists them in overcoming whatever constraints they may have. As a result, when Ethereum 2.0 is released and the fee issue has been resolved, it will have little impact on Polygon, proving that this is the fact that dApps, decentralized applications, aren't waiting for Ethereum 2.0 before moving to Polygon. The platform would not have over 270 dApps using it if they were waiting for Ethereum's new vision. In addition, its ambition to connect blockchains is resulting in several new collaborations. Its investors have high intentions to make it the third largest crypto project after Bitcoin and Ethereum, even though it's already among the top 20 cryptocurrencies. Polygon recently established a collaboration with Infosys Limited's consulting wing. MSETU is the name of this partnership. Its goal is for Infosys to be able to offer revolutionary technology to its clients. MSETU will serve as an open-source bridge that will allow businesses to interact with each other. Another significant Polygon collaboration is the Trace Network. Trace is now using it for NFT and DeFi to be a go-to for stores looking to sell NFTs to the general public. If a luxury brand wanted to make an NFT on their own items, the Trace and Polygon partnership would allow liquidity aggregation, comprehensive transparency, and supply chain traceability. It doesn't stop there, though. Polygon also recently announced that their project to integrate its assets into Google Cloud's BigQuery is complete. This connection has improved Polygon's accessibility and positioning. It now allows BigQuery users to tap into it. This means that users of BigQuery can now execute queries on Polygon's platform and access different blockchain-related datasets. New massive partnerships and well-known investors like Mark Cuban contribute to the popularity of Polygon. As we all know, the token's popularity is what pushes its value to increase and reach new all-time highs. Crypto experts even predicted price hikes of 5 to 10 times. They say that Polygon may easily reach $5 in a short time. Over 400 apps, 76 million transactions, and approximately 790,000 unique users have already used its scalable solutions. Its token, $MATIC, is traded on many major cryptocurrency exchanges, including CoinSwitch Cuba. Mark Cuban's investment is a significant step forward for Polygon, as this will bring additional investors into the US and into Polygon's ecosystem. Many eyes will get interested now that one of America's most prolific billionaire investors has personally invested in Polygon. They will try to continue and figure out its greatness and why Cuban invested in it. What are your thoughts on Polygon? Do you think it'll rise up the ranks and become the most popular cryptocurrency soon? Or will a sneaky competitor, whom no one has ever heard of, come in and steal the show? Don't forget to share your opinions in the comment section below. And while you're still here, go ahead and click on one of these two videos on your screen. See you there.